Hi to everybody. I will present joint work between the National Library Ivan Vazov in Plovdiv and the Institute of Information and Communication Technology in Sofia, both institutions member of Bulgarian National Infrastructure Quadra BG, which is related to CLARIN and Daria Europe. And in fact, the work here was done by Ivan Krichanov from the library, Laska Laskova from our institute, and actually by me. Okay, what is the problem? In Bulgaria, the publishing of newspapers and many books started relatively late with respect to other countries, from the beginnings of 19th century. And this means that in that time, there was not orthographical norm for publishing materials. And the process of evolving of such orthographical norm lasted almost 100 years. And we can imagine that from this time, there were many different changes and different publishing houses and publishing in general used some variety. So the pay period is very important for Bulgaria history and culture, but unfortunately there is not so much content from such publications. So our goals in this research is to build a good OCR model for all Bulgarian orthographical norms. And the second is because most of the language resources and processing tools for Bulgarians, of course, for the contemporary version of Bulgarian. So we don't need only the old publications in the old version of the orthography, but to transfer this to contemporary orthography. And here we can see some examples of the changes during the time between the two periods. Okay, how the solution that we started to build and built to some extent is, of course, the best model would be if we possible to make the OCR software to train it to recognize all the old scripts. And this is the first thing that we decided to do. For this, we needed some data to train it and also to transfer later on to the contemporary orthography. So we decided to go in two directions here. First, our the inflectional lexicon, which of course is for the current language, to be made in representation with respect to the old orthography. And in this way, to be able to train the model for recognition of old language, and also to establish a connection between the old orthography and the new one. And for the transfer to the text from old to the new language, we are going to train neural machine translation, let's say, between the two versions of the language. So these are the technologies that we envisage and working on. What was done in this period, in fact, is we tried to train the models on two levels. One is the symbolic level, where the program see the different symbols and it was trained to recognize them. And the other is because the system allows to fill with dictionaries to use the old dictionary in order to train the system. The results were tested up to now for some of the old materials. Not very exciting, but still positive. So this gives us confidence to go further in this research. What is our experience with respect to collaboration? So first, we considered the National Library as a treasure of knowledge, not just for the language, but for the whole culture of Bulgaria. And in this respect, we would like to turn as much as possible from the old version of the knowledge to new in the digital content of it. And so we took from the library in many ways different materials for which we didn't even know before we started to work together with the library. And we provide our resources and tools back to them. So I think this was of mutual benefits for both of the libraries. They evaluated the result for the moment on one source, but they are planning to do for more of what is available. And conclusions. As we saw from the current experiments, there is improvement in OCR, and we are doing now a creation of parallel corpora between OCR, TOLT, and new version of Bulgarian with the idea to train neural networks. And in future, our goal is not to stop here, but to go to process the content, indexing it with name entities, events, people, locations, and using this for one side to extract knowledge for the different periods represented in the data. And from other point is to provide access in different forms to the collections. And the collection is currently covering about 500 newspapers. So this is really a huge corpus to process.